stay calm even though everybody around you is losing it? Well, great question. How do you actually stay calm? Well, there's a couple of elements to that, but first I'll introduce myself. My name is Peter, I'm on the Bright Beats Academy, and I really want to get into this because there's kind of two elements to this which are really important. Really, the first one is about your physical body. What state is your physical body? I don't think anybody can argue now that most people on this planet are stressed, absolutely stressed out to the point to help. So I'm really anxious as well. What's going to happen next? Oh my goodness me, we've got a pandemic. There's all coming. What's happening? There's a food supply shortage. What's happening? What's happening? Anxious, the stress, the anxiety is all building up in the body. And this is not good because it puts us into the sympathetic nervous state, which is the fight or flight. So all the important energy and all the important blood supplies coming out to your exterior regions like your muscles, and it's making you feel you're going to fly away from something. The collapse in there, which is what mice do when the cat has really finally caught that mouse in the corner. The mouse makes out it's dead, so the cat loses interest. Well, the mouse hopes the cat loses interest before he eats it. This is where we're at now with you, which is the physical body. So learning to come into the parasympathetic nervous state is so important with meditation, Ki Gong, Tai Chi, yoga, whatever you choose to do, any mind, body, activity is brilliant. I love Ki Gong because it's mind, body, breath. So you're moving your body in synchrony with your breathing, and you're focusing your mind on both. You're learning to breathe deeply into the lower abdomen, which helps to stimulate the internal organs, which gives them more energy into the internal organs, which makes your body healthy and your immune system more working better. It's all brilliant, brilliant. And I love it. And so you're teaching your body to be more relaxed, moving with grace, and moving in harmony with your surroundings around you. It's a beautiful way of learning to be in the parasympathetic nervous state so that your body can keep more like this, can keep bouncing back into it rather than being in the stress state all the time. There's always stress, it's always good, but this really is important to keep doing that, which is why these practices are so important. So with this, you don't very often see our masters or masters and teachers getting that stress in this environment that they're true to their teachings, because they learn to observe the reality around them. What does that mean, observe? Well, this is the second part of it. What are you looking at these situations from? Like, whereabouts are you looking from these situations? Because the body has many elements to it. Are you your eyes, your mouth, your tongue, your taste, are you your hearing? What are the elements to your body? Are you your energy, the thing, the life force energy, or the key energy that animates this material body? Are you that? Actually, your many, many different elements. There's many aspects to you which makes you fascinating and multifaceted being, which is multidimensional. So you're a multidimensional spiritual being having a human experience in a physical body. Basically, that's it. That's what you are. In the Vedas, they explain it beautifully. They call it the chariot of the human condition. It's simplified, but it's very easy to understand, which is why it's simplified. So you've got the five horses and the five senses of your body, your vision, your hearing, your taste, your touch, your smell. So they're the five senses, and those horses in a lot of people today are bolted. And looking, the mind is being dragged out into all these experiences, but the mind wants to be stimulated. Nothing wrong with that. But if it gets overstimulated, that's where all the stress and anxiety happens. So the brains are what we would call the mind. The brains are the mind. So the five senses can pull the mind all over the place, which is why we call it the monkey mind. And it's about this point that the monkey mind jumps all over the place. It's really important to realise that your five senses are doing that. So you're being dragged in by the five senses. The charioteer is your intellect, i.e. the left brain, where you can make these decisions. Intellect can keep cutting, it cuts away until there's nothing left. It's not your intelligence, it's your intellect. And again, the intellect has taken over this world that we live in. carrier is your sense of self or your ego, so you can dress it up as nice as you like, or you can be as humble as you like. It doesn't really matter because it's just a shell. That's you, just a shell. This is just a vehicle, your body. And then what's sitting behind all of that is your energy source, your soul, your sense of self, the real sense of self, the real you, that just absorbs and sees this. So the more your five senses, your mind, the brains, the five horses, the brains, the charity, your intellect, and your ego, you connect with the soul, the sense of self, the more you learn to observe this life and respond to it, rather than reacting from the five senses, reacting from the mind, reacting from the intellect, reacting from the ego, you're reacting from this observer consciousness, which is difficult. It's not easy, it looks like it's easy, it's difficult, so you keep coming, you keep doing the work, which is why I'm saying about the material body. You do the Ki Gong work, you're moving closer and closer to this observer consciousness. And once you do that, then you start to become calmer, even in these really difficult situations. You become calm, you become, you can see it, you observe it, you learn not to react, because that makes it worse, you learn to respond, which can create healing and harmony and love, which is what we all have to go, we all have to love. So that's one, that's how you stay calm, even though everybody else is losing it. So if you need help with that, I do run a course called the Dream Method, which is a 5 steps for you to self-realize, and really based on emotional childhood wounds and anxiety and depression. We can help with all of that and more. Self-realization is a big journey, and that's a big step. If you are looking for that, you can click the link below, take you to the webinar. It's free to see if it will resonate with you. And then if you want to go further with that step, you can actually connect with me. And I look forward to speaking with you. If that's not with you, for you, not for you, that's fine as well. Just keep learning, keep growing, keep being the wonderful human being that you are. And until the next video, keep being well, keep shining.